Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you how I've been teaching text features in my classroom. I teach third grade, it's my first year, and I'm really proud of this. My kids love it, and I think it's really effective. So I wanted to show you guys. We are going to be diving into text features again right before the end of the year, and I wanted to do this project because it's a lot of fun, the kids love it, and I revamped it. So what I first do to teach text features is I have a PowerPoint presentation defining each text feature term. Now I think in each grade level they're gonna have different types of text features that they should know. So mine's for third grade. I mean, it's pretty simple and it's pretty fun. So at my site each month we receive Scholastic News articles every week, and I had no idea what to do with these. Again, I'm a first year teacher. These are really awesome and I just didn't know what to do with them. So then I thought about it and I saw a couple little things online, but then I'm like, I can make this like a project, like a 2-day kind of project. So, cause usually my ELA blocks run an hour a day. So I like to introduce the concept of text features in a PowerPoint first. So let me show you the PowerPoint I made. It is not the best, but it gets the job done and I tried my best on it. And again, I'm a first year teacher, so this is all like trial and error, but it went pretty well. Okay, so here is my presentation that I show the students. I made this back in January when we were working on it for the first time. And here's like the inspiration of the poster that I saw. Here we just discuss like why are informational texts important and how, like they help us find information easier and it helps us understand the information. And then we went over sidebars. So what I did is I just like found examples on Google and I just used like a transparent circle to circle and outline what the term is. So like sidebar, and we talk about what is its role and why is it important and why do we use it. Graphics, they fall under photographs, they fall under charts and timelines. And then we have subheadings, titles, subheadings, and captions. And this is probably one of the most trickier ones, especially with the little captions, but students mostly get it. And then our types of print. And that's it for what I made. So after I show the PowerPoint with the text features and we discuss what each text feature represents, then I begin with the project. And then we start on our project. So for the project, I just created this two pages. So two pages that the students are given and they cut out and glue onto a piece of 11 by 17 construction paper. So the construction paper looks like this and they're gonna fold it into a book and they're gonna glue it the way I have it. Now I used to do this with the kids writing it in themselves, but it was a hot mess and it's just so much easier to create this and print it and to have them glue it on than to have them write themselves, especially for third grade. And sometimes they took way longer than I wanted them to. This is a lot more quicker. First, I call it a text feature hunt because they're hunting through Scholastic News articles to find the different types of nonfiction text features. And I hoard these. And then I give each student 3 to 4 copies whenever we do this. So they have enough to pick from to fill up all portions of the project. The front part is the text feature hunt. They glue it on and they put their name on the very top. And something that I really focus on in my classroom, at least for third grade, is I always have the students practice answering questions using race. Restate, answer, cite, and elaborate. So that's something I always encourage my students to do. I think it's an amazing strategy and my kids are getting so much better at it than the beginning of the year. And I'm sure the fourth grade teachers will be happy if you teach them race in third grade. Okay. So I start by this and then here it says, text features are important and useful because, and this is something that we discuss when I show them the PowerPoint presentation. We're discussing this the whole time. So they glue that down and they're going to be answering this using race. So this is basically like our essential question in a way. We're really discussing why are text features important and why are they helpful to us as readers. And then here we have the examples of types of print. So we have bold, italic, and highlighted types of print. And here's my example. Then we go on the inside, and on the inside it says examples of titles and headings. They glue right in there. In here we have examples of subheadings. Then we get into examples of graphics, which are charts, timelines, maps, and pictures. We get into examples of captions. And on the back, we get into examples of sidebars. And lastly, examples of keywords. And through the PowerPoint presentation, we really talk about why each one of these are important, each one of the little like subgroups. We talk about why it's important and why they're helpful. So after I show them the PowerPoint, I always make an anchor chart to go with the skill for ELA, and I always have it hung on my ELA focus wall. I love it. That's one of my favorite things that I do. I love making anchor charts as a main focus of what we're learning about, because I like to focus on one skill a week and really dive in and get the job. Let me show you my ELA focus wall. So here's my ELA focus wall, and I actually used all this by cutting out Scholastic News articles myself. So we have, and I found this mostly from online. What I typically do is I just Google search like text feature anchor charts, and I just copy the ideas. So here we have, text features, why are they important, our titles and captions and subheadings, all of that. And this is just a good visual of what everything is. And I always have students, if they don't remember what a caption is, they come over and look at what a caption is, and it helps a lot. I know teaching text features can be kind of hard, so I feel like this is a really good interactive way how to teach it, and especially if you have a lot of these Scholastic News articles laying around. It's really fun, the students really like it, and it takes about maybe two days to do, unless it's an all-day kind of project. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching my video. I hope this is helpful. The main reason I watch teaching videos is to find new strategies how to teach content effectively. I want to be an effective teacher, and if I'm just stuck in my classroom all by myself, I can't really do that. That's why I think the internet is awesome. Sharing lesson plan ideas. So I hope that was helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will catch you guys in my next video.